Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. With the season drawing to a close, so much at stake in the fight for a playoff berth. They're lucky to have this man at running back for them, leading the charge toward the postseason. It's the Titans going up against the Steelers.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, at Heinz Field. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City, and a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with Marcus Mariota and the Tennessee Titans. Now here's Suck about to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. This one up to the 26. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And a peek now at the offense for Pittsburgh.
Antonio Brown just defies convention, because when you look at his build, you see a slot receiver, a short, shifty guy, but he makes many of his plays on the outside part of the field like one of the taller, rangier receivers in the league. Excellent route runner, tremendous hands, and fantastic with the ball in his hands after the catch. Antonio Brown's one of the best ones out there.
He'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Rodgers. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really nice gain of 25 yards. They'll look to throw now on first down. And his throw is incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And it's second down.
Here we go. Brad, 38.
Looking to throw. A strong running. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Call it a 3-yard gain, and just like that, it's third down. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well, but that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out, finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them. And we've seen the results of that. This team knows how to work through things.
Here we go!
A handoff as they run the counter play. Great move, but still wrangled before reaching the 20. Gets a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Now, prior to the snap, we hit all zeros as time has run out on the first quarter of play. 6-0 is our score. More from the Steel City coming up after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number 2. They've got it 2nd and 6 to start things out. There's another first down.
Come on, let's go!
They run the counter now on first down. And they're going to get him down, but not before a pretty good run right there. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Let's go!
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well on 2nd down and short. What I like to see.
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call.
And it's caught. It's Brown. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown. Suck about to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. James has got it. Complete. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
And some space here. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. Back now. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play. Thank you. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Let's go!
A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz. We're able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz got him into the right protection scheme so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
Over the middle, it's caught by Rodgers. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. The handoff as they run the counter play. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a
he'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Jurrell Casey coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. It's a pickup of 3, but still a little work to do on 3rd and goal.
What we're seeing from the defense here is a group of guys bearing down, trying to help out their quarterback after he threw an interception. Good stops on the first 2 downs. It brings up a key 3rd down.
So they took a shot. In his 10th year, here's Brett Kern to punt this one, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And he'll take this in at the 1-yard line. So we reach halftime. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken very short. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them.
But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A big play there. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
Now here's Suck about to kick it away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust. Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But
they're shutting them down on that play. Maybe try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag. That guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. In a 3-4 defense there and against the run, a lot of responsibility can fall on that nose tackle.
A ton of responsibility, no pun intended, because they got to deal with not just the center, both guards, and a lot of times they have to eat up double teams in order to let the rest of the guys get to the football. But how about that play? He not only eat up the double team, he ate up the ball carrier as well.
I was going to say, talking about puns, you said eat up the double team.
Here we go. One, nine.
Back to throw now on first down. Bryant with a catch right side. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once
motherfucker
again, last play stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
From the shotgun, here's Dobbs. And too much on that one. It's out of the back of the end zone, incomplete. Here's Brent Kern now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Let's go,
This will be fielded at the 17. And hello, he's going to be knocked backward as he'll be marked down. Second down, Dobbs got his man complete over the middle. It's James, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Breaks the tackle now with Allen. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 11 more on that one, and another first down. On first and 10, Dobbs. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Going to give this time to the tailback. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and 2 coming up. This is third and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game. He'll drop to throw. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. A gain of 10. Good for a Steeler first down. And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice.
Let's go.
Dobbs looking to throw on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
On second down, they'll try and run the counter. A strong broken tackle on that one. And then they get him to the ground just shy of the 15. He's able to rattle off 6 on the carry, and that'll get him to 3rd and 4. On 3rd down, he'll try and pick it up with a counter. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. Back now on EA Sports. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now the Steelers' offense gets ready to get back onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. And he can't corral it. That would have wrapped it up if he'd been able to hold on. Instead, it brings up 3rd down. So back-to-back incompletions, now 3rd and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Carl Klug in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
Partner, you absolutely cannot take a sack in that situation. Now, it's also 4th down.
He's back to throw.
He's going to let it fly. And that's caught inside the 35. An unbelievable play there on fourth and long. 57 yards.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got three timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Steelers, the great run they've been on continues as they move to 9-1 now. And they'll get a few extra days to savor this one before they take on the Green Bay Packers. Meanwhile, for the Titans, they're going the wrong way as this will drop them to 3-7 now on the year. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Indianapolis to take on the Colts. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from high.